Before I met my girlfriend, I didn't even know what love was. And I still don't. But I'm beginning to get it slightly. Because I feel like every relationship is like a delicately balanced game of Jenga. And the longer you've been dating, the higher that pile is. But when you fight, you start pulling stuff out. That's a dangerous game. Because when the fight starts, it's always about what has just happened. Like, hey, how could you just say that? Well, because 2 weeks ago, remember this statement? Oh, we're playing the remembering game. 6 months ago, in front of your friends, well, yeah, how about 8 years ago, 16 years ago, before you were born? You're like, oh. And when you run out of logic, you're like, you know what? Fuck you. Because fights start with logic and reason, but end with fuck you. That's what's left. When my friends fight with me, that's always step one. They're like, Kanan, we have a problem with you. And I'm like, hey, fuck you then. Why don't you fuck you right there? But when I'm fighting my girlfriend, it's different. Because she's saying stuff to me, she's mad at me, and I feel that fuck you. Coming from deep inside. Like acidity, burning. She's saying stuff, I'm like, you wait. You wait for this fuck you. And she's like, bah, 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 bah. And rises slowly in my throat. She's saying stuff. And it comes still here, but then sorry comes out. Which is weird. No, I mean fuck you. I mean fuck you. But I am saying sorry. Because that's what love is. It's a series of sorries that mean fuck you. Then you die. She tells me all the time. She's like, Kanan, why can't you just tell me what you think? Because then you would leave me. You have no idea. Let's just keep it that way. When you start getting in a relationship, that's the worry. Don't leave me, don't leave me, don't leave me. But real love is where will you go? Come back here. You date for long enough, you become codependent. You go from two separate interesting people and you become one boring person. Because your personalities cancel out. Loves to travel plus hates to travel equals travels sometimes angrily. I love Morocco. Thanks for bringing me. It's true, we have different interests, and I respect that. She loves traveling, I hate it. I love metal. Love metal, grew up listening to metal. She won't listen. 2 years, I've been trying to show her one metal documentary. It's 55 minutes long, she won't fucking watch it. Trying to set up situations like, hey, I wanna watch it. She's like, oh, I'm sleepy, some bullshit. So we've decided, we need to take an interest in each other's things, and the way we do that is, if one person is to make the other person do something they don't want, it must be a trap. I'll give you an example of a really good trap. One day she was like, you want to come to my friend's wedding in a month? I was like, of course, why not? No, radio silence on that for 1 month. The day before the wedding, she was like, hey, by the way, it's in Nepal. Well played. It's not like we don't do anything together. We recently went out for something called handwriting analysis. Like, I looked at my handwriting, he's like, oh, sir, you are very gullible. I was like, how do you know that? It was because you came here. You learn stuff also when you're in a relationship. Like, I learned I had blackheads. Didn't even know what blackheads were, but now I know they exist, I have them. If you don't know what blackheads are, they're small black things on your nose that only women can see. And depending on how much they like you, they'll put you in a headlock and remove them. This is basically an act of marking territory. Some other girl sees you in a bar, like, hey, what a cute guy. Oh shit, smooth nose. This guy's in a relationship.